Welcome to the YouTube channel of Nexus Classes. Here we are continuing the second chapter we had started, the 5-year plans in India. We had already discussed the long period goals and the planning commission and the Niti Aayog, etc. in the previous video. This video would comprise of short period goals and objectives of the plans, the features of economic policy pursued before 1991, and the success and failures of planning. Let's begin with the formulation of plans, their period and timing. The first plan began in 1951 and ended in 1956. The second plan began in 56, ended in 61. Third from 61 to 66. Then we had a gap of 66 to 69. Then from 69 to 74, 74 to 79. The plan of 79 was terminated in 78 due to political disturbances. Then we had 80 to 85. Then 85 to 90, then again gap, then 92 to 97, then 97 to 2002, and continuing till 2017. The last plan, 12th 5-year plan, was terminated in 2015 when Niti Aayog was launched by Shri Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister of India. Let's discuss about the plans, period, and their objectives, the focus of the plan or the principal objectives of the plan-wise. Beginning with the first plan, which began in 1951 and ended in 56, had its major goal of increase in agricultural production. Naturally, any country would want the first step to be self-sufficient in growing its own agricultural productivity. Then second plan from 56 to 61 had major focus on industrial production. The third plan from 61 to 66 had major focus on self-sufficiency in food grain production. Then we had a 3 years gap from 66 to 69. At that time, we had our annual plans. Then from 69 to 74, we had the plan and it focused on accelerating the process of growth. Then from 74 to 79, it was focusing on raising the living standards of the weaker sections of the society. Then we had annual plans. Then sixth plan from 80 to 85 focused on removal of poverty, reduction of inequality and development of infrastructure. Whereas the seventh plan from 85 to 1990 focused on generation of employment opportunities. Then we had a gap and then the plans went on with a few objectives. Let's now discuss the features of economic policy pursued under planning till 1991. On the whole, we can say that the focus of planning has always been on achieving better quality of life, that we can say as inclusive growth. The features focused on as heavy reliance on public sector. Economic policy prior to 1991 basically wanted that everything must be controlled by the government solely. They wanted the regulated development of private sector. Like acts like IDRA, which was launched in 1948, completely wanted the private sectors to be limited. Then protection of small-scale industry and regulation of large-scale industry through MRTP Types Act, Monopolistic and Trade Restrictive Trade Practices Act. Then they wanted to develop heavy industries of strategic importance only on the priority basis. Then focus on saving and investment. They wanted to promote saving by offering interest rates, good interest rates to the public, and offered investment via subsidies and capital grants in income tax. Then they wanted to protect the domestic work from foreign competition. They wanted focus on import substitution. They didn't want to get anything from the foreign countries. They wanted their own people to make things in the domestic country. They restricted the foreign capital via FERA Act, the Foreign Exchange Regulation Act, and the planning was a centralized one, centralized planning. Everything was controlled from the center. These were the major objectives of the planning pursued before 1991. Now let us discuss about the achievements and the failures of Indian economic planning. First of all, let's discuss the achievements under economic planning. There were various achievements that we were able to achieve due to the economic planning, like increase in national income. Increase in national income indicates the economic growth, and yes, we were able to achieve that. But during most plans, we actually failed to achieve the targeted rate of growth, but still, we were better than we were performing earlier. Right? There was increase in per capita income. Over time, per capita income has recorded a significant rise. During the first plan, it was 2.7%, whereas during the last plan, it was 5.5%. We were able to increase the rate of capital formation. Capital formation means to invest capital in good business houses, and yes, we were able to. There were so many institutional reforms in agriculture, and green revolution was a major recognizable achievement. There were developed industries and infrastructural development, the railway network, etc. There are many social services that have increased over time. The time has modernized, and even our economy has been able to. And the government has been successful in increasing the employment opportunities for the population. But with that, we were failed at many points. Let's discuss the failures of economic planning. As we faced no substantial increase in the standard of living, the slum areas of Maharashtra are still the slum areas. Unemployment with increase in population remained to be a major point of discussion. There are unequal distribution of income and wealth cases. The paradox of saving and investment still remains a trap for people. The predominance of welfare consideration. There are not profit maximization chances still facing the economy, and productive sectors could not face major growth. Hence, these were our all over achievements and the failures of economic planning. Economic planning help in mobilizing and allocating the resources in desired manner. And to conclude, we may say that its objective was to reduce inequality and promote economic growth, balanced regional economic growth with modernization. The 12th plan has taken off, and Niti Aayog has taken the charge. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for listening the video. Please review in the comment box. Like the video if you have been able to understand the chapter through the video. Thank you from the Nexus Classes.